Hey guys, Coral Blind Wave.
I'm Eric.
Rick.
I'm Calvin.
Aaron.
And it's time for a mailbag. You see this? It's going off the table!
Yeah. Alright. We got it.
Hello. Thought it was an America Online CD at first.
I didn't use it.
You kind of used it. It's right there. It's sticking out.
You used it.
See it, everybody?
Yep. There it
no,
is.
No, I ripped it from here.
No, right there.
Give it.
You got it.
See?
Yep.
There it is.
Oh, we got stickers?
Stickers.
Stickers.
You say?
Stickers. Stickers. 10% off stickers.
Oh, you.
He's shooting a blue ball at us.
We have an army.
Of this guy. Whoever this person is.
You say, right?
I don't know.
I like me a good holographic sticker. You know, really want to watch the show.
This show is about cloning.
I'm not kidding. It's a good sticker. I'll put that sticker on my laptop, but I can't until I watch it.
Yep.
On your laptop. But then it's on your laptop.
I would love mine on my laptop.
There.
That was the goal. You're right. Thank you.
I don't like putting stickers on things. So I feel like eventually I'd want it off, and they're always hard to get off.
They're not hard to get off. Use Goo Gun.
Alcohol,
yeah,
Goo Gun.
I don't want to use it on my laptop, Eric.
Don't
now
use it
my
on
keys
your laptop.
Are all
use
messed
it
up
one
and stuff.
To a washcloth, and then you do it.
It'd be terrible.
His eyes change, too.
Oh, cool. Oh, really cool.
No. One down.
If you're interested in seeing a reaction to the opening of UU, you can go on our Cameo. I believe it's available to everybody on there. Right?
Mm-hmm.
I don't remember.
Could be.
It was public.
Aha.
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 And 10% off.
Aha.
If you can zoom in on this QR code, you can have it.
Yep. It's yours.
Neat. Oh, I have an idea what these are. Eric, do you have an idea what these are?
Dice. Necklaces.
Popcorn.
Popcorn? What's wrong with you? What makes you think it's popcorn?
Why was I called out?
Blind Wave. Be brave. Lol.
Is it a check?
It's cool. It's not a check. Dear Eric, Rick, Calvin, Aaron, and the rest of the crew, I found your channel when I was 14 through your Doctor Who reactions. I am now 20 and still enjoy all your content. Most recently, I watched Game of Thrones and then proceeded to watch every single one of your reactions. Ha ha!
That's a lot.
Wow, when I saw you were starting Swifty Saturdays, I decided to make you some special friendship bracelets.
Oh, how I know that?
You fool.
For the journey, I've been making and selling bracelets for a long time, and I've been a Swifty since I was 3.
Wow. 3.
Impressive. Wow. I hope you enjoy Morgan. 7 Blind Wave, 4 Star Wars, 3 Swifty Saturday, 1 Doctor Who, 1 Bebo Loves You, 3 Game of Thrones.
Those are the ingredients of the bracelets?
If there's anything else you like, let me know. The colors are inspired by the leather-bound books of Game of Thrones.
Oh,
and P.S.,
wow.
If Aaron gets mad about the Bebo bracelet, please slap him for me. Okay, we will.
We will.
It's an Andre the Giant bracelet over there.
These are
cool. What's on them?
These are cool. The Targaryen sigil.
Oh, fire and blood. Those will be good for House the Dragon coming up.
Game of Thrones. Neat.
This one is empty now. This one is a Game of Thrones one.
And these no! Calvin, what have you done?
This wasn't me.
Wasn't
I didn't do this.
See, I didn't have that issue when I did it.
You were lucky. Swifty Saturday.
I bet the Bebo one's in there. It cursed
no.
it.
This is the one.
There's Which a
one
blue one.
It's a Swifty Saturday one.
Oh.
We will get it fixed. We're filming a Swifty Saturday tomorrow, I believe.
Tomorrow's not Saturday.
They get filmed.
Tomorrow was Monday.
Eric, look. Yep. Look at this. It's a shit bracelet.
Oh, it is. Oh, it says Sith.
Oh, damn, I tried.
This is cool.
Oh,
I'm so
cool.
Careful.
Here's a light.
The beads went everywhere. Damn it.
Light side.
I have such an aversion to putting bracelets on, because usually they bust before I get them on my wrists.
Well, here's a Doctor Who one. It's got a little TARDIS.
Here's the dark side.
Yeah.
And here is it's just straight up
side, you are
Star Wars.
Here's your bracelet.
I don't.
We blow want your planet up. What is thy bidding?
I don't. I don't cool. want it. I don't. I don't love him. Ow! I'm not mad. Now I'm mad.
Yeah. This one comes with a little tiny letter Sweet. Opener. And another Swifty Saturday.
It's dangerous.
Yeah. A letter opener. Let me see that.
Like you can just put this on. And then you have like a little sword just right here, and you can be like, hello, how are you?
Gotcha.
No one said I had to wear this.
You got mad about it, so.
Bebo.
Ooh, bracelet. Bunch of blind wave friendship bracelets. These are cool.
Oh, blind wave ones.
There's that. There's a bunch of blue ones.
Bebo.
Blue wave.
Yeah, is that purple?
Bebo.
Is there a blue wave one?
No, there's not a blue wave one.
You got blue wave. You got a little green ball.
Sweet. I'm sad for this other Swifty Saturday bracelet that, unfortunately, it looks like it got untied.
Yeah.
Or it disintegrated somehow.
Disintegrated? Disintegrated?
Ooh, disintegrated.
Just a part of it. Most of the beads are still here. Maybe we can try and reassemble it. I think there was a couple that fell on the ground.
Calvin actually saved the bracelet.
Mostly.
Sorry, we're very bad. These are awesome. Thank you. I will leave these two on for Badonkagonk today.
Yeah. I like all the stickers on your letter,
If I take Blind Wave plus Star Wars, you get Wave Squadron.
That's true.
There's not even a Q in those letters.
There's one of the beads. Thank you, Morgan.
Thank you. Thank you, Morgan.
Roar. I don't know what this is. Here you go.
Right.
Zip, zip.
A letter to Blind Wave. Hello again, Blind Wave. It's me, Benjamin Tarawali. Tarawali.
Yep.
Tarawali. Come again with more questions and answers this time.
Questions.
Mm. Hopefully everyone was here to read their part of the letter again. For Blind Wave. After Naruto Shippuden, are you guys planning on watching Boruto? It's very hated, but I really like it.
It's very hated. I don't know anything about it.
I guess I know that it's hated now.
We have no plans for it right now, but if people want it after Naruto, then they will be able to put it in their recommendations.
Update your recommendations.
Mm-hmm. After you finish Naruto, will you do a podcast on it?
Probably.
Only after we do Boruto.
We have some time to figure it out, but probably. Boruto.
Here
are some more anime for you guys to watch. Fullmetal Alchemist 2003. It's better than Brotherhood. Let me explain. Don't read if you plan on watching it someday. Be warned.
Rick has seen it. He said it's pretty good.
It's very good.
Brotherhood's also very good.
Brotherhood's great.
We want to read
and
that.
And it's official.
Officially great.
Blind Wave, you should give Sword Art Online a chance.
I've watched it.
These guys watched it.
Really I unfortunately good. Watched it.
It is great.
No, I enjoyed it.
It was good show.
You know what's not good? Sword Online and Bridge, in my opinion.
That was also really bad for me and for Eric. I can say that with certainty. That's not opinion. That's objective.
I haven't seen it. I know you guys didn't like the abridged version of Sword Art Online, but the actual show is amazing. Its soundtrack, great fights, great story, and emotional moments.
Mm-hmm. Very good.
A show you guys I know would love is Durarara, my third favorite anime of all time. And it is dear to me. Hmm. Some amazing voice actors that are in it that I like are Bruce Papenbrook, Crispin Freeman, Johnny Young Bosch. There are other incredible voice talents there that I know you would love. It's very bizarre, random stuff just keeps happening. That's why I love it. It's very dialogue heavy, though.
I want to know what the first two anime are, then I can judge him on the third one.
His top two?
Yeah.
Maybe he says.
Like if his top two are like Hunter, and I don't know.
You actively want to judge him on his likes and dislikes.
Yes.
Yeah. He's only his third favorite. I want to know what his first two favorite are. Like, oh, I know those ones. Third one must be good.
I want to know the company in which that show keeps.
Or is the fourth one like Full Metal Alchemist Brotherhood? And I'm like, well, that was pretty good, so this one must be real good. And I gotta know the first two.
Exactly.
Also recommends Carol and Tuesday. Has one of the best first episodes, and it's also a music anime about two girls, a rich and a poor girl, trying to make it big.
Okay. Its title doesn't grab me, but it sounds better.
Not quite two broke girls. It's one broke girl and one rich girl.
Yeah.
But maybe the poor girl's rich in talent. And the rich girl, poor in talent.
Poor in talent and rich in talent?
Yeah.
Or maybe they're just friends and the money doesn't really get between them like that.
It's too crazy even for anime. Rumbling Hearts. I'm sure Rick and Maggie would love this. Basically, it's about a relationship that is in-depth with tragedy.
Tragedy. What kind of tragedy?
That's up my alley. Fate Apocrypha. This is another Fate series you guys should watch. It has my favorite Fate, some of my favorite Fate fights of all time.
Been
takes
a while.
The game to an interesting level.
We have it on collectible boxes.
It's been a while since we watched a Fate show.
It is.
I wouldn't mind going back to a Fate show at some point here. It'll be fun.
Maybe.
Finally, Valkyrie Drive Mermaid. The show is bonkers. It's an ecchi series I'm sure Aaron would love because it's a redheaded character with a power system. Is basically if you turn on a girl, they turn into a weapon.
Whoa! I love it. I want to watch that.
I want to watch that with Aaron.
Speaking of English voice actors, who are your top 10 voice actors? They don't have to be from anime. They can be from cartoon.
Ooh, that's tough.
Love Crispin Freeman.
Dee Bradley's great. Jim Cummings is great. Those are the first two, I think, of just because of like, all the different voices they do. And you find them all over the place.
Chris Sabat will always stand out to me.
Chris Sabat.
Dan Castellaneta and Billy West were major inspirations for me early in life. I mean, Steve Bloom.
Tara Strong. And who else did I put on that list? I can't think of her name. Liz Hera. Why can't I think of her name?
Marshall.
Vanessa Marshall. Marshall. Yeah. I host a Star Wars podcast. I should know this.
Vanessa Marshall. This person has a top 10. Brandon Potters, Shanks from One Piece. Brittany Karbowski, Hitch from Attack on Titan.
Okay.
Greg Ayers, animal-looking guy with the quirk from My Hero Academia.
Gotcha.
J. Michael Tatum, Irwin.
Oh, yeah, of course.
Tatum.
So
yeah.
Good. Chris Sabat, we all know who this is, except Aaron.
I know who Chris Sabat is.
Sean Schimmel, Aaron probably doesn't know who this is either.
That's a Goku, but I don't know him in anything else, and I don't know him as Goku.
Yeah, same.
I don't know if I've ever heard him perform.
You don't know his power.
But I know All
Eric,
Might.
Eric has showed me his some screams power. That were real good.
I know All Might.
You will not destroy my world!
Colleen Clickenbeard, probably my favorite voice actress. She is a better voice actor than Sean Schimmel in terms of range. She plays Luffy from One Piece, Momo from My Hero Academia. Think about that. If you don't believe me, pull up a clip of Luffy alongside a clip of Momo and see the difference.
Awesome. It's crazy. And what a great name. What was the last name?
Clickenbeard.
Clickenbeard.
Yeah, Clickenbeard.
Yeah.
It sounds like... Did you watch Power Rangers Zia?
Nope.
All right.
I'm sorry. You can still say it.
The bad guys is like this clock machine empire.
Yeah.
I just pictured Clinkenbeard being like one of those guys, but he has a beard too. He's a Clinkenbeard. Be great.
Okay.
But
be like if Blackbeard were into clocks instead of setting himself on fire.
Aaron Dismook, or Dismookie, who plays Senku.
Yeah, that's it. I was like, I know that name.
Get excited.
Ian Sinclair, Tsukasa. And Jerry Jewel, Kyo.
Also,
from Fruits Basket, I believe.
He also plays, is it Sun Eater, I think, Senku?
Yes.
I also like Tara Sands, which is the voice of Bulbasaur. And I also like Shelby Young.
She's
a newer voice actor, but I've seen her do some really good stuff. And then she's been in a lot of like Star Wars things. She's done like Princess Leia voice and stuff like that, too.
Remember when Bulbasaur sang you happy birthday. Said your name. Bulbasaur. It's crazy.
Bulbasaur.
Benjamin wants us to give a score from 1 to 10 of some of the animes we watch on the channel. We rank them as a podcast.
We do.
They are ranked. You can just, they're all ranked.
Just look at all the S tiers.
The ones and the S's are definitely 10s. And then just give them less numbers as they go down.
Yeah.
We'd like your opinions on some of them, such as what you disliked and how they rank. Check out that podcast.
We talk at length about all that stuff.
Each one of them, yep.
Very much so.
Here's some more underrated anime I would recommend. You watch at your own time. Birdie the Mighty Decode. Batum.
Batum.
Eden of the East. Magi, the Labyrinth of Magic, To Your Eternity, Air, Another, Black Lagoon, Blue Exorcist, and Batum Again.
Another Batum.
Batum Again.
It's just there twice.
It must be really good.
So it's not like a sequel series called Batum Again.
No.
Batum.
No, I recognize two of those.
There should be... the sequel should just have four O's instead.
Batum!
Will any of you guys play Naruto Ninja Storm games? You're already far ahead enough in the anime that you guys can play.
Oh.
But only play up to Storm 2.
I think I've already played one at E3. I didn't know who any of the characters were. I was like, that old guy looks cool. I think it turned out to be Jiraiya.
Yeah.
I think I played Storm 1. I think I played the first one. It was a long time ago.
I never played one. That would be fun.
For Eric, since you're a big Dragon Ball fan, are you ever going to read the manga of Dragon Ball Super?
Maybe. I've read the manga of Dragon Ball and Dragon Ball Z, a little bit of Super, but, you know, there's arcs right now that I'm assuming will one day be made into the anime. I kind of want to save myself for the anime.
Since it's coming back and they're doing more of it.
I mean, they're doing Dragon Ball Daima now, which is not the stories that have been done in the manga. But I have faith that we'll get to them. And I know a little bit about them, and some of them are quite exciting in terms of, like, well, where would you like to see this story go? So, but right now, yeah, I think I'm just kind of... I can be very patient when it comes to it. So, for a rainy day, I can read the manga if I know for a fact it'll never happen in the anime. But I'd rather prioritize the anime.
It's supposed to rain today.
The anime and manga are two separate things with different stuff happens. You can read it from the beginning. Mm-hmm. Also, will you be playing Dragon Ball Sparking Zero when it comes out?
Yes. Sparking. Yeah, I played all the Budokai games, and this is that spiritual successor. And the roster is nuts. You thought Ultimate was nuts. This is like Ultimate times two.
Yeah.
Yeah, they were throwing out characters just like, you know, and this person's in it, and this person. I'm like, this person's in it? Why? But cool, you know?
There's like five different cells. Yeah.
They had some, they showed some characters from History of Trunks recently that I go like, oh, I've always wanted this in a game, yes. So that's going to be fun.
Also, Dragon Ball Daima is coming this year during the fall. Since you and Rick watched the live-action One Piece, will you ever watch the anime or read the manga on your own time or have it on the channel?
The One Piece manga will be watched once a year.
The anime.
Oh, the anime. That's what I meant. Manga, though, that could be fun. I mean, I know it's a lot, but...
It's less than the anime.
Berserk was a lot, and I got through that. This is pretty quick.
This is for Aaron.
Aaron.
This is for Kingdom Hearts.
Oh.
Did you know that it's been 5 years since you last played a Kingdom Hearts game, and that was Kingdom Hearts 3?
Yep. I played through, like, I think almost everything up to that point.
You're going to have to play the DLC named Remind. It has important story information for the next game.
I played it. We did it on stream. I don't believe any of it was saved or VODed.
VODed.
So it might be lost.
It was lost.
I streamed that and I streamed Remind.
Mm-hmm. Last time I wrote, you were under the impression that you had finished all the recap for Kingdom Hearts Union X. There's still more you have to watch. The finale for that game released 2 years, I assume, later. It's a real amazing recap. You should watch a recap on your own time or dedicated stream. It leads to the future of the Kingdom Hearts series. For the Melody of Memory rhythm game, it's not just on Switch, it's on PS4 as well.
Yeah.
You can watch a recap of that too. Don't forget to watch a recap of Dark Road as well.
But if you get it on the Switch, I think it gives you a song in Smash.
Really?
There's something like that that you get if you... Cool. I forget what it was, but there was something on the Switch where like, if you had
you
it,
mentioned
you gave
that,
it something.
Yeah.
The next time there's another Kingdom Hearts 4 trailer, I really hope you aren't confused. Take your time. Also, how much do you love the Kingdom Hearts series? What would you rate out of 10?
I mean, it's one of my favorite as far as, like, RPGs. I never used to like RPGs, but more of them have changed nowadays to where, like, the new Final Fantasy VIIs are a little bit more like that style, where it's, you can move and change what you're doing as opposed to the turn-based that I didn't like as much.
Mm-hmm. Tails has been doing that for a long time.
But, I don't know. I think that it has some complications in, story and titles and stuff too that make things confusing for people, especially when you're like, oh, 1, 2, and 3. If I just play those, these ones are spinoffs. But then it's like, no, these ones are important too. So it gets very confusing. So I'll give it like an 8.
Mm-hmm.
But I think the story and the characters and the gameplay is really good.
I get jealous when some people love those games. I'm always like, hey, if someone loves something that much, there must be something to it. Yeah. I want to get into it. And then you're like, where do you start?
Oh, they'll tell you.
Starting's easy, but where do you go?
Where do you go? Because, yeah, those titles are a little
intimidating.
You only
start with one, but then it's like, what do you do? And then there's like, oh, well, here's, I think it's called Rechain of Memories. Mm-hmm. And you're like, oh, well, this basically goes through a lot of the first game. But there's new stuff in there that also is relevant to future stuff. So you're like, well, I guess I'll play this again so I can get this.
I think at one point I watched a Video Donkey video of him explaining the timeline of Kingdom Hearts, and that was endlessly entertaining.
You should convince the others to play the game before 4 comes out. Hey, Aaron, can you tell me why you're scared of needles? Is it just an act you put over the camera, or are you legit scared?
It's not an act.
I made my glasses fog up when I got my blood drawn. Like, mm-hmm. my body changed temperature so much that my glasses fogged up, and I've never had that happen before.
He was sweating, he was feverish, so much that he was evaporating his own sweat so quickly.
I don't know how that happened.
The inside of his glasses fogged up.
It was weird. It wasn't like I was in a hood.
No.
It was weird.
He was in an open, well-ventilated room.
Melanie filmed it, so. Yeah.
And as for the origins, you were attacked by a roaming band of seamstresses? What happened?
That was later.
That was later. That wasn't the cause.
I paid them.
Yeah, that's right.
That was the escalation.
That's when you guys were like testing. Like, you sure he's afraid of needles?
Yeah,
Calvin's
mean,
like,
I
I'll
lying.
Find out. Yeah. You're like, all right, Calvin, you find out for me.
Little boy, no!
I was talking with, I think it was Melanie's parents the other day, and I don't know if it's what stems, like what started it all or what, but I do remember... I remember having to get my blood drawn when I had my appendix taken out, and it was like every night. And that wasn't as bad, I just really didn't like it, and it hurt.
Yeah.
So whenever we had the C8 testing, I think that was after.
Yeah.
But it could have been before, but
it
I think
was
it was
after.
They took like 4 vials, and in the hospital for appendicitis, I had like a stress ball that I was able to like squeeze. So I'd like would squeeze that stress ball while they did this, and I was like focusing on this. Like, focus on this, leave this alone. They like make your fist, and I just not move. Mm-hmm. When I was there, I didn't have my stress ball, and then I tried to like just kind of like move my feet like this and just focus on them. And the nurse yelled at me and said that she wouldn't do it if I wouldn't hold still. So I couldn't even like wiggle my feet, and then all I focused on was that, and then I passed out. And then my mom was there like trying to give me like we had like Wendy's or something like that. She was trying to give me like pop to try and get my sugar up or whatever. And, I don't know. Maybe that stemmed it from, like, the nurse yelling at me.
Sounds traumatic.
Like, hey, don't move or I'm not going to do this. And I'm like, but just don't move. I'm going to stop. And it was, like, a threat. Like, okay.
So for all you trained nurses out there, work on your bedside manner because you could scar someone for life.
Yeah.
And he gets taken advantage of it by his friends.
Those nurses were expensive.
Last time, you said you had watched Degrassi, The Next Generation. How much have you seen?
I don't remember. I remember watching it as a kid. I remember Drake's story a little bit in there, and I remember like a few things, but it's been a long time. My sister might remember better than I do. Mm-hmm. I'm gonna say not much because it's I can't tell you names or anything.
For Rick, I'm just going to list my favorite anime so you can judge them. So now we get the top 3. Hopefully, you'll be here this time. Number 1, Naruto, 10 out of 10. I can't judge it because I haven't seen it all. Fruits Basket 2019, 10 out of 10. It's hard to disagree.
I would give Naruto an 8.
An 8?
I think it's great, but some of the pacing and...
You take Naruto aspects, and Shippuden all together?
Yeah, I think so. I think the story and stuff's great. I love the characters. There's just... And it's a thing of its time, but the pacing is the toughest part about it.
Yeah.
But that's just what they did back then of what they had. You know, every week we got to do it, not seasons, you know? So they couldn't like wait a little bit. But what's good is real good.
Yeah, up to what I saw is probably a 7. Probably.
When it's great, it's 10.
Yeah, it's real good.
Definitely.
When they have you watch the same stuff for 3 episodes, it's a
3. It's a 3.
Durarara, number 3, 10 out of 10, which I haven't seen. Nor have I seen Carl and Tuesday or Erased. Fate, Stay Night, Unlimited Blade Works Season 2, specifically 10 out of 10. I prefer 0, but Unlimited Blade Works was pretty good. Heaven's Lost Property, 10 out of 10. Haven't seen. Nor Platinum or Rumbling Hearts. A lot of 10 out of 10s. Thus Spoke Kishibe Rohan, 10 out of 10. Violet Evergarden, 10 out of 10. Attack on Titan, 10 out of 10. Attack on Titan is very good.
Mm-hmm. I'm pretty sure I've seen Violet Evergarden. That was good.
Dr. Stone, 9.5 out of 10, but only because it has no ending yet. Which, I agree. I don't think you can rate anything 10 out of 10 until you finished it.
Until it's ended.
10 billion out of 10.
But you can definitely say it's terrible and not worth my time.
Yeah, for sure.
Okay.
Yeah, yeah, because it'll never reach a 10. You know, at a certain point, right?
Never?
Yeah.
Never.
Yeah. Yeah, like if you watch
your opinion
a season and it's a 1, it will never reach a 10 because that's always going to drag it down.
So, 4 episodes, it's enough for damnation.
Yeah.
But not enough for praise.
such a hard line.
Get a gold Olympic medal in a sport. So you ever lost a sport? Well, once. Get us back!
You don't get gold.
4 times.
No 10 out of 10 for you.
You lost 4 matches.
Apare Ranman. Again, no ending. 9.5 out of 10. Hagane? Valkyrie Drive Mermaid.
Oh, I want to watch that one. What's up? We rate that one.
9.5 out of 10. No ending.
There's no end to the titties.
They didn't say they were titties. They said turn them on and they are weapons.
It's an itch.
Where do you think the triggers
are? There's definitely going to be something.
What, you think? This is their...
Sure.
A Planet After Story, 9.5 out of 10. Some issues. I've played the visual novel, but I haven't seen the anime. Assassination, and it's very good. Assassination Classroom, Season 2, 9.5 out of 10. Some issues.
How are you just picking seasons?
I'm doing it once.
I want to. He said to judge, and I'm judging.
Ash Class was my favorite, but I enjoyed more than I disliked. Fate Apocrypha, 9.5 out of 10, some issues. Fruits Basket, I assume the original, 9.5 out of 10 did not follow the manga. But there's some episodes towards the end that are anime only that I absolutely love.
You gave me this.
Fullmetal Alchemist, 9.5 out of 10, some issues.
Fullmetal Alchemist.
The first one, right? Not the Brotherhood?
Brotherhood is 22. Also, though, 9.5 out of 10.
Brotherhood's great. I love Brotherhood.
I need to watch Brotherhood. JoJo Part 4, 9.5 out of 10, some issues. Which I haven't seen JoJo. The Heroic Legend of Arslan, 9.5 out of 10, some issues.
Arslan?
Junai Taizen, 9.5 out of 10, some issues. I Want to Eat Your Pancreas, 9.5 out of 10.
Sounds like issues. A Hannibal, like, anime.
As is Tokyo Ghoul, I believe, 9.5 out of 10, some issues. Agame ga Kill, 9.5 out of 10, some issues. And then Unranked, Sword Art Online 2, and My Hero Academia Season 6. But I must say, having 28 shows that are at least 9.5 out of 10 or 10 out of 10 is a wondrous life to be living.
It is. That is true. I probably have shows like that. Yeah. They're just not all anime.
Yeah?
Yeah.
I don't know. But I'd be happy to rank them. When is the last time I watched One Piece? I'm still in Water 7. I haven't watched it in a while. Mainly because Evie hasn't wanted to watch it. It's too much for her.
Too much? Like, so, too many episodes?
Trying to wait. No, too much emotion.
Oh.
For Calvin, I did not know you had ADHD.
Yep.
Truly sorry.
Neither did I. That's all.
I think that's it.
Cool.
Thank you very much, Benjamin.
Just want to keep your attention.
Thank you.
Thank you so much.
I'll have to check some of these out. I haven't heard of a good deal of them, so there's so much more to find and enjoy.
This is from Russell.
Russell.
It's in a comic book bag.
I would guess a comic book.
Me too.
It doesn't look like a comic book, though.
It doesn't seem sleeve and board. Is it like a collectible book or something?
I don't know. We got a letter. This is Russell Berger, who sent this.
This is Blight, a tragedy of Galdric the Brave. Mm-hmm. So it looks like a published book.
Neat.
Blight. Ooh, beautiful letterhead from the desk of Russell Michael Berger. May 15th, 2024. Hi, hey, Blind Wave crew.
Hello.
I feel unsure about how to start this letter, because saying, it's me, Russell, implies that you know who I am on a first-name basis, and that surely isn't the case. But to start with, my name is Russell. Also ignores the fact that I've reached out and communicated with you guys before. So, I hope that you can see the conundrum that I stand face-to-face with as the beads, as the sweat beads up on my forehead. Ha!
I understand that. Like, meeting people sometimes, like, hi, Aaron. Yep. Like, hi, I'm Aaron.
Yeah. like, I know. Just, I've watched you every day.
Who are you, person?
What's your name, please?
But I guess that actually gets the introduction out of the way, right?
Thank you, Russell.
No matter, I'm sure you've seen the book when you open the package, so to the point I go. I'm an aspiring author, and to this point thus far, I've self-published all of my work. I sent you guys a copy of my second book, Jom, a while back, and expressed how you guys inspired me to go for my dreams and to never put less than your most into it. And well, I'm now sending you my latest book, Blight, the Tragedy of Galdric the Brave. Did you ever hear the tragedy of Galdric the Brave? This book is a collected volume of an online exclusive 12-episode miniseries that I did, which is simply called Blight. But I wanted to collect it and get it to a wider audience because not everyone likes reading from the screen of their phone. Mm. And so I collected it into this book. But wait, there's more. It also contains an exclusive epilogue episode that can only be read in the collected volume. I figured, why not spice it up a bit and give those who go out of their way to grab a physical copy some extra goods.
Nice.
Now, I'm sending you guys this because I've kept going. I wanted to show you guys my appreciation for being creators who've inspired me not to give up on my dream. And I wanted to make sure that other Wave Riders out there hear that you can't give up, that they can't give up on their dreams. You gotta keep going, especially when times are the toughest and you just gotta push through the black clouds to bask in the warm glory of the sun. It's too often that we give up right before we're about to make it. And so I hope that Wave Riders out there who are pursuing something they love hear that and never give up. Anytime I wonder why I'm doing what I am, I always think of a quote by a great man. The quote is, I've never seen a man regret something more than the thing he could have done but didn't. So push on, Wave Riders. Push on. Again, thank you guys for being you and making amazing content. I truly hope to meet you all in person one day. Sincerely, Russell Michael Berger.
Thank you, right. Russell.
Thank you, Russell, so much.
That was lovely.
Congratulations on the newest book.
The stories in this are inspired by the creation of other stories such as Star Wars, Green Lantern, Dune, and others.
Ooh, nice. Neat. Okay, cool.
Awesome. And there's, what, 12 chapters.
Yeah.
So it's the 12 miniseries. And then the epilogue, yeah, that must be the extra thing that he was talking about, too.
No, that's awesome. My favorite thing we do is that we get to experience stories from such a wide array of storytellers, and knowing that there are storytellers that watch us and get inspired is just as fun.
Yes.
Yeah. So thank you so much.
Hopefully we get to meet you one day.
Mm-hmm.
We do have WaveCon coming up, and maybe having them again in the future at some point too, so just keep eyes out for that, or if we end up traveling for any conventions or anything.
Yeah.
So it's always fun to meet people.
Yeah. I would say we could have your book signed then, but
you already signed it.
Gracefully already signed it for us. Thank you so much.
May the force be with you.
Mm-hmm. Oh, nice. Cool.
Thank you, Russell.
Thank you.
Enjoy your gift from Steven.
Steven.
Adventures, Pokemon Adventures. Ruby and Sapphire.
Ooh, okay.
Omega Ruby, Alpha Sapphire, actually. But awesome. Thank you, Steven. This is volume 2. I don't know how much of this one we have.
Yeah.
I know we have a lot of, like, the main series.
Sure.
Mm-hmm.
Now, the Pokemon manga is actually different than the Pokemon anime in terms of story, correct?
Typically, they follow, like, the general characters.
Yeah.
sometimes you have a little overlap in the games to the shows.
Okay.
But, like, the manga follows, like, the initial one follows Red and Blue and not Ash or any of that. So it's kind of a weird mixture between the it's more pulled from the games, I guess. But not, like, the show who made a character rather than it being kind of just empty. If you've watched, what was it? Pokemon Origins?
I have not.
There was a short series that was just on YouTube, and they had, like, Red and Blue, and it was more of, like, the games. It's a little closer to that than it is, like, the Pokemon anime.
Gotcha. Okay.
But even still, it's also different, and they have a lot more stories in there.
Yeah. Awesome. Very cool.
But thank you, Steven.
Thank you, Steven.
Yeah. Maybe at some point we can do something with this like we do with the Star Wars comic that we started over on Wave Squadron.
That'd be cool.
Maybe read through some of these and
like
see
how
the...
Like a manga podcast kind of thing.
See how the story plays out. I know some people do that with like other manga readings and stuff on like One Piece or something. So.
Yeah. Yeah. We'll have to, if we do that, it'd be fun to... have you ever read much manga?
Not a lot of it, no.
You gotta teach yourself to do it backwards. Like first page on this is, you idiots, this is the last page. Read this way.
Is that what it says there?
Yeah. So you gotta start here and go right to left.
I already mess up reading in comics.
I know. That'd be fun.
Yeah. It's really difficult to remember because you have to read the text left to right.
I know.
And then you have to move over here and read it left to right.
Yep. Yeah. Yes, you do.
It's strange. But it's because the art was drawn that way. And the book was bound and then translated later.
Thank you, Steve.
Thank you.
This is to all of us.
Everyone.
Looking away, I thought whatever that noise was came out of the package.
Like a glitter bomb. Alright.
Is it a Pokemon card?
Oh no.
I don't know. I think they're little. Ah! They're Yu Yu stickers!
Stickers.
More stickers!
Yes. More stickers!
25th anniversary!
They are
all
the same sticker packs.
Cool.
And there's four packs of them, so we each get one, I'm guessing.
Thank you.
This is from Kristen.
Kristen!
Thank you. Thank you so much.
Kristen!
Such a great show. One day, I believe.
Eric, tons of stickers.
I know.
All great for your laptop.
Are these...
You can cover your laptop
of
in these.
The quality... They're that cool. You would put on your laptop, Eric?
Yeah.
The laptop quality.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, they are. There were some Zelda stickers I got here the other day that I rejected.
Oh, yeah.
I got them.
Yeah, Aaron took them. These are too sexy.
What's wrong with sexy stickers?
Nothing. Just...
Well, then put them on your laptop.
Respect for my princess is what I'm saying. And there was also one that was AI.
Well, yeah, that one like, that one wasn't as cool anyway.
That's not anything.
Thank you, Kristen.
Thank you. To all of us, mouse pads.
Ooh.
Yeah.
I like it.
I really like those.
I like it a lot.
Yeah.
Ooh. Wait, I just want the green one.
What's the bag for?
There's
You each get a bag.
Gift bags?
I guess, yeah.
Let's cut them all into fours, and I'll take everyone's green corn.
No, then you have a weird thing in the middle.
That's just a plus sign.
No, you would have the rounded corner.
Does not say, Kristen.
Oh.
But I would guess.
That's who it's from.
Then it'll be a weird, like, pinwheel shape.
I mean, you're a pinwheel shape.
If we need these bags for anything, but they're kind of nice.
Yeah.
Well, now you can carry yours, Eric, to the mouse pad location.
Yeah, you can use two fingers to carry it instead of...
It is literally two fingers.
Two fingers.
Thank you.
Thank you so much.
There's letters within the letter.
There are.
Letters.
Sweet.
We just got some letters.
We got Disney Princess sticker party pack.
Oh, Eric.
I think Buffy stickers.
Baby is going laptop.
Mouse pads.
Oh, there's just a lot of
We got okay, some cool. Play Pokemon stickers.
Play Pokemon.
Yeah. Pokemon. The Play Pokemon logo is quite cool, too, but those are some really cool stickers. And Aaron, we got this really cool Pikachu charged up gift bag.
Ah, I bought this exact one
really?
For Something.
Yeah. Oh, something.
That's cool.
And then we got a card. It has all of the zodiac signs on the front.
Interesting.
Dear Blind Wave, thank you very much for my birthday cameo.
You are most welcome.
I appreciate it very much. I'm so happy you were able to watch the opening to Yu Yu Hakusho. Cool. After watching the opening, what were your thoughts? Does it look like something you would enjoy watching in the future? Hopefully soon, it wins the next polls. Smiley face, Kristen. Thank you so much. No, it looked great. Anytime you watch an opening, especially when you are ignorant of the actual show, you anticipate being like, wow, maybe I'll understand all this one day.
Yeah. Sure.
So I had that feeling, but it does look very intriguing, and the love that it inspires in people is what I'm most intrigued by, so yeah. Hopefully we do get to watch
it. Music and visuals are really good, but it is one of those things where you get like, I wonder what this all means.
Yeah.
Sure. What is this?
The best openings for one of the best shows.
Mm-hmm. Well, thank you so much, and we're glad that you liked the cameo.
Cameos! Yu Yu Hakusho.
Notebooks.
Here's your notebook.
We might now just have enough for the series.
Here's a notebook.
Oh, they're different.
Yeah. Oh, they are different. I was going to say.
And here's a notebook.
There's an itemized packing list. I was like, well, if they're all the same, why do they have quantity one, quantity one, quantity one?
Yusuke?
Yusuke?
Hiei?
Yay.
Kurama?
Kurama.
And Cool.
His name is cut off.
In what?
I don't know, it's K-U-L, but that's all his name is.
Kuwabara.
I was close. Get him! Thank you, Kristen.
Yes, thank you so much.
I will continue to assume if people do not put other names on him, they're from Kristen.
Yes, we'll continue. Yep.
I don't know what this is.
Whoa! Oh my gosh!
But I don't know if it's this or that, which one's bigger. So we'll go that one, we'll open that one.
That one by volume, this one by dimension.
No!
Why?
He's a dick. What a jerk.
Because there was a ladder.
Chaos? It's like there's a ladder right there.
There
I don't
is.
Think that's what he's talking about.
And a pole.
Whoa!
Whoa.
Happy birthday.
What? Holy crap!
This is the biggest birthday card I've ever seen.
Look at that!
Here you go.
Oh my God!
Happy birthday, Eric! Hope you have a wonderful day. Having a birthday is like reaching a higher peak on a mountain. Pause to admire the view. Reflect on how far you've come.
That's how I play Zelda.
This is cool.
Holy crap! I've never seen such a large birthday card.
This is quite large, and it's actually kind of hefty.
Yeah.
Try it out.
Oh my gosh.
Ah. Just glad it's not one of the ones that plays music. We'd all be deaf.
Jumbo greeting cards.
Yeah, jumbo.
Never gonna give you up. It just keeps going.
I love all the choices you made from the selections too.
What are they?
All of the posed pictures.
I think he has made this one off the website.
There's our Christmas photo shoot.
Uh-huh.
There's the WaveCon ad. There's more Smash Brothers Married to College. There's Bridgerton. There's the merch. Ad. There's the React poster.
Promised Neverland.
Promised Neverland. I don't know what this one's for.
That's just a social.
That was a WaveCon social post.
Yeah, WaveCon social post for WaveCon.
Well, thank you so much. This is certainly the biggest birthday card I've ever seen. I feel like I won. This is like Publishers Clearinghouse gave me a birthday card. This is amazing. Thank you so much.
Wow.
You could hang that on your fridge and have room for nothing else.
It'd be the door.
Yeah. It'd be the door. Makes sense why the box was like that. It was like an envelope.
You can just stand it, like, on a table, and it will just, on a floor.
It's true.
On anything. On the roof. Ugh.
This is from Tiffany.
Thank you, Tiffany. I'm enjoying this quite a bit.
We have a Lego race car.
Ooh. Not just any race
Fast
car.
Fast and Furious.
That is a Skyline.
Yes. That's a Brian car. Mm-hmm. Rick, you want a knife?
No.
Rick.
Don't.
Rick.
Ah!
Pokemon.
Hey, look at
Loki.
Loki.
This is actually quite dense.
Grand Theft America, The Ultimates 2.
Huh.
Ooh, comic.
Cool. Okay, cool. It's got an interesting texture. That's cool.
Flash, Young Barry.
Flash.
Ah.
Oh, Wonder Woman.
Ah!
Pokemon Battle Figure, Vaporeon.
Oh, oh, cool.
Gosh.
Squirtle, Translucent.
Thing.
A translucent Squirtle.
I thought you meant the character from The Boys.
Thank you, Tiffany.
What about Tiffany?
Oh, Loki.
Yeah.
Ah. Everything?
Let it happen. It's gone this far. Ah. Huh.
Aha! Power Rangers Jason Pop.
Oh, really? Sweet.
Oh, not again.
Critical Role Scanlan Pop.
Oh, Scanlan.
Cool. Scanlan's hand.
He's in his hand.
He is in his hand.
We have a TY Beanie Baby Bear who's named Cody. When I scratch my back, it's something to see. I'll stand up and rub it against a tall tree. Birthday, February 7th.
Oh.
Percival from Critical Role.
Oh, like Kodiak. Sweet.
Vex from Critical Role.
Cool. Oh, cool.
Pike from Critical Role.
Nice.
I'm gonna get a hands going.
Oh, God, look at this splash page.
Ah, Keyleth.
Keyleth.
Grog.
Yes. Ooh. Yes. I want to see Keyleth.
Whoa.
Look at this.
That's a hell of a page.
This is a one splash page.
Damn.
It's a double centerfold.
It's amazing.
Huh. Crazy.
I've never seen that before.
Neither have I.
Did you open this one?
No.
They sent all this one of them. Wow. Yeah. Only this one. They sent Jason in his place.
Yes.
We have a Superman puzzle.
Keyleth.
We have magnets.
Oh, these are rattlesnake magnets.
Are they really...
Oh, no. Should have been more gentle.
See, Rick.
Is a Captain America mech?
Yeah, it is.
Pretty cool.
I will fix that, Calvin.
We have a Batman Hot Wheel, the animated series.
Ooh, yeah, it's purple. Too far apart.
There's the Dark Knight Rises, the bat, the flying thing.
You guys care if I open this? The Batwing?
Do it.
What is it?
What is it, Eric?
Oh, yeah. It's...
We have Lilo and or Stitch.
Now,
Stitch.
What's the difference now, Eric? What is it? What
is it? It's purple.
What is it, though?
It's the Batmobile from the Ant-Man series. The good one.
Oh. Here's another piece of cat.
Purple.
What, purple?
Yeah. It's a finger.
And we have a Paw Protector.
A Paw Protector? Cool.
Paw Protector?
Pop.
Batwing.
It was quite the haul.
Yeah.
Can we open this, Eric? This is a collector's item. What's that one?
This is the Batwing from Dark Knight Rises.
It looks like the tumbler.
Well, it flies.
If you're dumb.
Wow.
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 No, it does. It's made by the same.
It's like a tumbler kind
of. It's a similar design aesthetic.
How are you going to do something with those magnets?
Whoa.
She just said no. But I've been doing that.
It's a
great, it's
such a great sound. I didn't hear that sound before.
Thank you everyone so much for everything that was sent, the wonderful letters, the fun toys. Thank you. If you wish to send something, you can look down in the description below at the P.O. box.
Birthday cards.
We do mailbags every other week. Yeah, they're good. Happy birthday, Eric.
Eric Kitch!